Recovery centers in Utah need to be regulated. That's the law.
But one man who runs recovery centers says the law is against the law. Our Matt Gebhardt has been investigating.
Shauna, on 2 News at 4, I showed you how a recovery center here in Utah has been unable to take in parolees who need a place to go. As our investigation continues now, there is a fight brewing between a man who ran several recovery facilities and state regulators. The state says recovery centers should all be licensed as businesses. He disagrees. This ordinary-looking house in Sandy used to be a recovery residence where people who were addicted to drugs and alcohol could live together and try to stay sober.
I'm in recovery myself. I do it to help other individuals.
Alan Anderson owns the home and about a dozen others, which largely took people in after they got out of jail.
And they need that home environment with an alternative family that supports them and loves them.
But his business has dried up. Not because there are fewer people who need help, but because of a law change that Anderson thinks is just plain wrong. In 2014, Utah passed a law requiring recovery homes be regulated. Anderson does not want the added hassle or expense, which he says he would have to pass on to the guys who move in, people who can barely afford the rent as it is. But fighting back has been expensive too.
It's been a huge disaster, financial ruin. Many houses closed. We had 12. We're down to one because of that.
But we now have 100 licensed recovery residences throughout the state.
I took it to Brent Kelsey with Health and Human Services, who says other residential treatment centers have been willing to comply with the new law. And he argues regulation is important.
Were situations where people were mandated by the courts to live in a particular place, you know, a sober living environment, but when they showed up, there were people actively using drugs and alcohol.
Getting licensed can be a cumbersome process. Not only must the state license you to operate, you also have to get a business license from the city.
Do you have a business license at your house?
No.
We shouldn't have to either.
Ted McBride is Anderson's lawyer. He thinks that requiring a business license for a home is illegal.
It's not a business.
Okay.
Because there's no reason to regulate it in the first place.
If somebody's profiting, that's a business. Hotels are just places that keep you warm.
You're mistaken. You're mistaken.
Explain to me why I'm mistaken. Explain to me.
I don't have to convince you. I have to convince the judge.
While NXLevel and their lawyer weigh their legal options, they say addicts who need a place to go are being denied good beds. McBride and Anderson have filed a lawsuit against the state of Utah, but it was dismissed this past May for lack of prosecution. McBride says they intend to appeal. If you got something you want me to investigate, give me a call. My number, 801-839-1250, or you can email me, Gephardt@KUTV.tv.